my age particularly, there's no why me about this. It's my turn.
13 years after he left the Des Moines Register, the Iowa boy is still an Iowa institution, but lately he's been facing some real grown-up problems. For more than two decades, Chuck Offenberger's must-read columns capture the essence of what it means to be an Iowan. Today, Eric Hanson caught up with the Iowa boy at what's become his home away from home these days, and that's the hospital, right, Eric?
That's right, Kevin. In the last 18 months, the Iowa boy's found out that he's had lymphoma and fought it off twice, and now he's in preventative radiation, all of which has equipped him for the next chapter in life.
When friends land in the hospital, entire neighborhoods snap into action.
Yeah, we're ready for Chuck. Okay.
Some make a hot dish.
I could see in people's faces that they're worried, you know, and I'm good, because I'm a little worried myself. This is serious stuff here. So here's the big machine.
When doctors drop the word lymphoma on the Iowa boy,
they always say, you're in great health if you didn't have cancer.
An entire state says a prayer.
At one point, Carla and I counted up, and we had people praying for us in all the major religions of the world. And it was like, who gets that? I felt like I've been buoyed up.
This month, it's daily radiation in Ames.
We'll get started here.
Last November, it was a stem cell transplant in Iowa City.
I've been through about as much cancer treatment as you can go through, I guess.
But in true form, biopsies, surgery, and chemotherapy haven't rattled the 63-year-old boy next door.
The fact is, the cancer's under control right now, so I really feel good. I feel the best I've felt in 18 months.
A stretch in which his wife Carla's battled cancer, too. Now that they're both recovering,
we're going to work hard at paying that forward and helping other cancer patients in time and others who need help in times to come. Secondly, we're going to start being a little less responsible. Things we wanted to do, we're going to go do.
Proof that hair might fall out, but humor doesn't have to.
If I face rough times ahead, I'm still grateful for the opportunity to get well now, and which feel like I am. See ya.
And it's a little too soon to bike the Burr ride in February, especially with no hair when it's so cold. But he's hoping for at least a few days of ragbri this summer, the cycling enthusiast that he is. Chuck's very open about his cancer and writes about it often at his website, which we've posted a link to at KCCI.com.
It has been incredible. He has been incredibly open, incredibly honest, and it has been a fascinating website for years and years, but especially so in the most recent months.
As always, great to read.
All right.